In our previous class, we have talked about leaf and the structure of leaf. Today, we are going to discuss the different functions of leaf. There are many important functions that leaf are performing. So, let's discuss one by one. So, the first function of the leaf is making food for the plants. Who is making food for the plants? Yes, leaf is making food for the plants. Now, how they make food? So, let's discuss. The leaf prepare the food for plants using sunlight, chlorophyll. This is chlorophyll. Now, what chlorophyll is? It is a green substance present in the leaf. Okay, if a question is asked to you that why the color of leaf is green, it is due to the presence of a substance. That substance is chlorophyll. Fine? It gives the color to the leaf. Fine? Now, another thing, they use carbon dioxide from air and water from the roots of through the roots from soil through a process called photosynthesis. Right? Ab ye kya hai? What photosynthesis? This is a very, very important term, and this is very important that you just read further in your higher classes also. So, what photosynthesis is? It is the process in which the leaf prepare the food for the plants by using sunlight, chlorophyll, carbon dioxide and water. And the process is called as photosynthesis. Simply, I'll just write here what is happening. We use sunlight, fine? In the presence of sunlight and in the presence of chlorophyll, the chlorophyll, what chlorophyll is the green color present in the leaf, sunlight, chlorophyll, carbon dioxide. Simply we write, one thing you note, simply we write carbon dioxide like CO2. This is the symbol for carbon dioxide, fine? Plus we use water. What we use? Water. And what is the symbol for water? That is H2O. Okay? These things, sunlight, chlorophyll, carbon dioxide, water. These things are used by leaf to prepare food. They are preparing food for the plant. And the process in which all things is happening, the process is known as nothing but it is known as photosynthesis. Hope it is clear to you. It is very, very important. Okay, now see the second function of the leaf. What second function of the leaf is? That is the exchange of gases. Like we breathe, we inhale oxygen and we exhale carbon dioxide. Similarly, plants also do inhalation and exhalation. It means there is an entry of gases and there is an exit of gases. Now, from the which part of the plant this entry and exit of the gases takes place? It is nothing but it only happens through the leaves. In the structure of leaf, there are small pores present in it. Fine, pores means tiny holes, you can say. Tiny openings are there. Okay, in a structure of leaf, if there is a structure, right? In the structure of leaf, there are some tiny openings, right? That openings are very, very small that you cannot see with your naked eye. It needs a special type of microscope to see that tiny openings, fine? So, with the help of these tiny, this tiny word means very, very small, fine? Very small that you cannot see with the help of naked eye. Now, what it is? How exchange of gases takes place? The leaf of the plant, they allow the entry and the exit of the gases like carbon dioxide and oxygen. We denote oxygen with O2. Through the tiny openings, tiny means very, very small. Through the very, very small openings, and these openings are known as stomata. What is? It is stomata. They are the tiny pores, tiny openings present on the surface of leaves that you cannot see with the naked eye. It needs a special type of microscope, fine? So, with with the help of these tiny openings, the entry and the exit of the gases takes place. Now, let's discuss the third function. Now, see the third function of the leaf. The third function of the leaf is the loss of water. This we have already studied in chapter water, that there is a transpiration. This transpiration word we have used in that chapter also. What transpiration was? It is the loss of water from the plant to the atmosphere. Fine. Now, how this transpiration happens? This transpiration happens from the surface of leaf. As you know, on the surface of leaf, there are very tiny openings. That tiny openings are called stomata, right? It means from stomata, the plant evaporates to the atmosphere. It means the plant water goes into the atmosphere. There is some loss of water. Now, the loss of water, it happens through the stomata, and this process is known as transpiration. This we have already studied about, that what transpiration is. Fine? Okay. So, when the transpiration happens, it keeps the plant cool. You have also observed that sometimes the plant in the evening, they are very cool. Why? Because the transpiration happened there. Now, we will discuss some modifications of the leaf. As we have already discussed that why we do the modification. To perform the better functions, the modifications of the leaf, they are there. Fine. So, we will discuss some modifications of the leaf. Now, we will discuss some modifications of the leaf. For the first modification of the leaf is protection. As you know, the grazing animals, they graze leaf of the plant. So, some plants, to protect themselves, they turn into thorns and spines. Whenever these leaves, they are modified into thorns and spine to protect against the grazing animals. Fine. So, that the grazing animals, they can't eat them. Okay, so the example of this is cactus. What happened in cactus? The leaf of the cactus, it has some thorns or spines, as you can see. Okay, why they are? Because to protect themselves from the grazing animals. And the second modification, this is related to the first modification. Whenever there are the spines, some desert plants are there. As you know, in deserts, there is a very less amount of water. Fine. The amount of water is very, very less. So, if there is a transpiration happen there continuously, then what happened to the plant? It will die after some time. For the reduction of, or you can say that for prevention of loss of water, that less amount of water is lost by the plant. So, these spines help. Fine. Whenever the spines of the desert plant, they reduces the loss of water in that plant. Now see the next modification. The next modification is tendrils. About tendrils, we have also studied in the modification in stem. Okay, so what tendrils are? You should know that tendrils are the thin spring-like structures. Fine, like this. They are very thin spring-like structures. Some these kind of structures are developed in the leaves. Now, what they do? The tendrils help the plants to climb up, taking the support of nearby tree or structures. Fine. So, which plants need the tendrils? The plants which is having very weak stem, they need tendrils. Fine. So, what tendrils do? Tendrils help the plants to climb up and take the support of nearby tree or structure. The example of this type of tendrils developed in, that is sweet pea. The next modification is for the storage of food. Now, the leaves also store food. You have seen the onion. Okay, which type of skin onion has? It is having a very fleshy scale leaves. Right, means very, very thin leaves they are having. Now, the onion has fleshy scale leaves on a short stem because their stem is very, very short and which store the food. Fine. It means the food is stored in the form of very fleshy scale leaves. And this structure is known as bulb. Okay, whenever there is a storage of food in the leaves, the structure is that is created, that is a bulb. Okay, so what we have learned today? We have firstly learned the functions of leaf. What functions of leaf? The leaves help in the production of food, exchange of gases. And the next function was the loss of water, means transpiration. After that, we have discussed the modifications in the leaves, that why do they modify? Okay, they modify to protect themselves by creating thorns and spines and to prevent the loss of water. After that, for if the stem of the plant is very weak, so the tendrils are developed, and also the food is being stored in the leaves.